Hey, this is Ed with AtticFoil.com, and today I'm in the attic to give you some tips and tricks on how to install the 26-inch wide version of AtticFoil inside a truss-built attic. Now, this is actually not a truss-built attic, but I put in one jack support here to kind of show you what it'd be like. Now, of course, in a truss-built attic, you'd have these jack supports going all the way down the framing. Normally, in a stick-built attic, you would run that 48-inch product horizontally across the rafter, but in a truss-built attic, because of all the jack supports going all the way down the attic, it can make it real tricky to try to do this. This is why we have the 26-inch product. It's specifically designed to run vertically on 24-inch center trusses inside a truss-built attic. It's actually 26 inches, and because of that, you have enough material to completely cover the bottom of each truss or each rafter on either side. Truss attics are sometimes actually easier to install because once you get the size of foil, it's going to be the same size piece all the way down the attic. The first thing you want to do is pre-cut all your pieces of foil. You want to measure the distance from the top plate of the wall all the way to the ridge, and then reduce it by a few inches to allow a gap at the bottom and a gap at the top. You want air to be able to flow freely from the soffit and either go underneath the foil between the foil and the roof deck or to flow freely into the attic. And then you want to leave a gap at the top for air to go out of the attic. Once you've got your pieces pre-cut, it's best to start at the top and work your way down on one side of the truss. Now here's the trick. What we're going to do is we're going to staple it to one side, or the left side in this case, go all the way up and down. I've already done this piece on the left side. We're going to go all the way across and do one side. Just let them hang. And then we're going to come back, fold them up, and staple them across as we go. That way you can easily see where the truss is. As far as stapling it up, you start at the top, and when you get to a support, the easiest way is just to staple about 5 or 6 inches above it, and then wrap it around, line the foil back up with the truss, and just keep going. You can usually staple every 2 or 3 feet, that's all it takes. Once you have all the pieces stapled on one side, then what you're going to do is you're going to come back and just pull them across and staple to the rafter on the other side. You can just pull them tight and they'll line up every time. It's really easy this way. When you get to the supports on the other side, you're just gonna do the exact same thing. Now you've got a couple different options here. You can staple it up high, pull it around, and staple on the bottom just like we did before. Or let me show you another option. If you want a cleaner look, you can take a knife, cut a slit there, and that, when you pull that across, put a slit right there, staple it, bring that thing around to the bottom, put a little slit right here, you can wrap that, and it makes a really clean, good looking finish. It's really not necessary, but some people like it a little prettier. That's everything you need to know to install 26-inch wide attic foil inside a truss-built attic. Just staple it up and get it done. For complete information, visit atticfoil.com, your complete online source for radiant barrier foil.